Hello, ma'am. Ma'am, we would like to know about yourself.
Presently, I'm heading the Department of Computer Science and Engineering in West Bengal University of Technology. But basically, my background is electronics, and I have, previous to this, I was in Calcutta University. And for the last 20 years, I've been teaching analog and digital communications in various levels. I've taught in MSc class, I've taught in undergraduate BTech, and I've also taught advanced analog and digital communication to MTech students of my university.
Ma'am, my second question is from you. Since you have recently, your book has come out from Pearson Education, Analog and Digital Communication, what are the main features of this book, ma'am?
This is basically a book on the fundamentals of analog and digital communication, and I have tried to highlight all the basic concepts that are needed to be known for a student to understand analog and digital communication. And since communication is an ever emerging subject, it is very difficult to write a book which will cover all the topics. So the aim of this book is to prepare a student with the fundamental concepts of analog and digital communication on which one can build upon. So a student will be able to learn themselves about all the new areas which emerge in the future.
Ma'am, how this book is different from the other books which are there in the market?
The most important thing that I feel about the other books that are in the market, they are good, no doubt, but in the present scenario, they are a bit difficult for the students to grasp. In the sense, they deal things in great depth. And before a student's understanding of the fundamentals is complete, a student is rather diffident to go to the depths. That becomes a problem. So during my tenure as a teacher, I've been teaching lots of students in different levels, as I've told you. And I've found that in the Indian scenario, there are two problems that are cropping up. Number one, the strength of English is not what it used to be earlier. The books that we used to learn, we used to read during our student days, were mostly written by foreign author, and presently the students can't grasp those languages, that English, in such very easily. So my aim is to put things in a more simple way so that it is easily understood. That is the first point. Second point is, I've tried to write the whole thing in a step-by-step manner, the way I have taught in the class, and I have found results. So I have tried to use the same method. I have included almost all the fundamental concepts that are required, and wherever there are mathematics, I have tried to give some derivation just to teach the students how they can derive, how they can understand, how can they prove the points. So that is there. Other than that, in most cases I've tried to build up by giving block diagrams. Basically it is the main concept, the logic behind the basic systems that are used. So I hope it will be easier for the students to grasp this book, and at the end of each chapter I've given an exhaustive list of references. Because I feel nowadays, when we have to complete a course within a semester, within a limited time, normally we cannot have more than 14 weeks per semester. If a student has to understand a subject, one has to understand the fundamentals first and also in a very structured form,
right,
so that they can develop on that later on if they are interested. So for that there should be some guidance regarding what are the key books that will help them to learn more.
Now my final question to you is, how is the experience of writing this book for Pearson?
Pearson is a very hard taskmaster, I would say. They have made me revise the book, which I would have done otherwise, but in addition to that, they have provided me with the syllabus exhaustively of most of the major universities, so I could make this book not specific to one university but a little more general, and they have also made me make out a lot of questions and solving those questions so that it becomes easier for the teachers and the students alike to understand and follow the book.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for giving us your interview.